Greetings from Hollywood, ladies and gentlemen. You know, scientists are continually working to bring us greater efficiency and more speed in aircraft. And so in tonight's play, No Highway in the Sky, we tell you the story of a rather absent-minded scientist who, because of one transoceanic flight, found himself the most talked-about man on two continents. As the stars of this intensely absorbing drama from 20th Century Fox Studios and recreating their original roles, we have one of the most capable actors on the screen, James Stewart, and one of the most glamorous women in the world, Marlene Dietrich. Yes, glamour is an international word, just as Lux Toilet Soap is an international complexion care. Because lovely women everywhere who want fresh, lasting, new beauty depend on daily Lux facials. Now, No Highway in the Sky, starring James Stewart as Theodore Honey and Marlene Dietrich as Monica Teasdale, with Evelyn Eaton as Marjorie Corder. One of England's proudest possessions is the aircraft establishment at Farnborough, where some of the world's finest commercial planes have been developed. It's closing time, and one of the officials has just left the plant. With him is a scientist, Mr. Theodore Honey.
It's very kind of you to drive me home like this, but I assure you that
Yes, you've told me several times, Mr. Honey. You could just as easily have taken the bus.
I always go home on the bus.
Mr. Honey, I'm rather curious about that experiment of yours in the vibration shed. Perhaps Sir John told you I've been away for several months, and now that I'm back, may I ask just what you're up to in there?
Well, yes, I'm vibrating.
So I understand. The entire tail assembly of the new Rutland reindeer is suspended in midair, and you're vibrating it. Why, Mr. Honey?
Well, I'm waiting for the tail to fall off.
Oh, I see. But these planes are already in service.
Yes, they are, yes.
Sir John tells me you're an American, Mr. Honey. Rhodes Scholar, eh?
Yes, I've been here for several years. I can't remember exactly how long I've been here.
He's quite proud of you, Mr. Honey. Tells me you're invaluable. But what are you trying to do to our reindeer aircraft?
Well, that's rather difficult to explain in words of one syllable.
I have managed as many as two syllables on occasion, Mr. Honey.
Oh? Well, very simply, the purpose of my work has been to arrive at an end result for the original theoretical hypothesis of Kerslinger of Baal and Schilgard of Uppsala, in which they postulate vibration as a source of energy. Now, I reason that since this energy does not appear in any of the ordinary forms, such as heat or electrical potential, it must be absorbed by the metal itself, and that sufficient absorption would result in nuclear fission of the aluminum atom in an isotopic form with crystalline affinities.
And what all that means is that the tail will fall off the airplane?
Exactly, yeah. Oh, here's where I live. You wouldn't care to come in.
Thank you, I'd like to.
You would? Well, I'm afraid all I can offer you is some sherry.
Well, that'd be very nice.
It's probably not very good. I've had it quite a while.
Well, perhaps it's time to see if it's suffering from fatigue.
Oh, that couldn't happen to sherry. Oh, no, you see, sherry is that's strange. I'm sure this is the right key.
Where?
Oh, I'm so sorry.
This is the second time this week, Mr. Honey.
Oh, yes, this row of houses, they all look alike.
Yes, they do, don't they?
Yes, it's the one next door. You know, it's very easy to make such an error, you know.
Especially if you've just moved into the neighborhood.
Oh, we've lived here 11 years. Oh, this is my house right here. I'm sure this is my...
Good evening, Father. I'm glad you're not late. I have everything planned for... Oh.
Hello.
Hello.
You don't recall where we put the sherry, do you, dear?
The top cupboard, behind the dishes. You said it would be out of Mrs. Higgins' way.
Oh, the top cupboard. Oh, yes, of course. Yeah, I remember perfectly. I put it up here behind the...
Yes, Father?
It appears to be empty. I guess Mrs. Higgins found it after all. Well, I'll get some more.
Please, I wish you wouldn't.
Oh, no, it's no trouble at all. The shop's just around the corner. Elspeth, will you entertain Mr.... I don't believe you told me your name.
Scott.
Scott, this is my daughter. I'll be right back.
Well, Elspeth, now all these books are your father's, I suppose.
Oh, yes. They're all over the house. It's very difficult being a scientist. One has to think so much.
Oh, I know.
When my father's working, I keep very quiet.
And what about your mother? Does she help you keep quiet?
My mother's dead, Mr. Scott. An air raid during the war.
I'm very sorry, Elspeth. You must miss her very much.
Yes, I do. My father does more, I think.
And what do you do when your father's not busy?
Well, quite often we play games. He makes them up. For example, we play pyramidology.
Pyramidology?
It's based on the science of the Great Pyramid, and it's very scientific. The Great Pyramid is the only known architectural example of squaring the circle. That is, the area of the base is directly equal to that of a circle with the height of the structure.